Consumers and the public are concerned about animal welfare, and Canadian farmers know that the way they treat their animals affects the quality of the food they produce. Dr. Luigi Faucitano of the Dairy and Swine Research and Development Center in Sherbrooke has developed several innovative techniques for improving the well-being of animals and the quality of their meat. His work has shown clear and positive links between animal welfare, improved productivity, and the quality of the product.
I'm Italian, and I come from a pork-producing region. Parma ham comes from my region, so I especially love pork. I work on transportation of pigs. In Canada, pigs are generally transported in potbelly trailers with three decks. There's research underway that's aimed at keeping this type of truck, but improving it by improving the environment inside the truck and making it more comfortable for the animals being transported. They experience all kinds of stress, such as interaction with humans, changes in their environment, and the movement of the vehicle. There's vibration, there's noise. The animals are subjected to a physical stress because while they're moving and walking, it's very stressful for them. So they get fatigued, and a fatigue is a physical stressor that affects muscle activity. The final product is the meat and the quality of the meat. And when a muscle is exhausted, there's not enough sugar, which is called glycogen, in the muscle. And the process of converting muscle into meat is negatively affected. My projects are multidisciplinary. So they're projects where I have several scientific collaborators working with me, along with their teams, of course. We apply stress, we make the animals walk for a long time, we transport them, we handle them in a certain way, and afterwards we look at the quality of the meat. Normally at the farm, when the animals are ready to be transported or sent to the slaughterhouse, they're not fed. That's the first phase. If an animal's stomach is full when the animal is put on the truck, there's a risk that the animal could die or vomit while being transported. It's been demonstrated that not feeding animals for 24 hours before slaughter represents a saving of 2 kilos of feed per animal. So that's an economic advantage. And later, once the truck has arrived and is waiting to be loaded with pigs, the handler enters the pen and starts bringing out the animals that are ready to be sent to the slaughterhouse.
Several of the strategies designed by his team have been adopted as best practices. The industry is becoming more and more aware of the advantages of animal welfare and now sees it as a marketing tool, especially internationally. International contracts include strict specifications for handling, driving, and transportation.
We're doing a lot of work now to support the industry by researching the tools they need in order to control the conditions under which the animals are slaughtered. In fact, to control the chain from the farm to the slaughterhouse. And if they can control it, they can make improvements and correct mistakes. The research I do is very applied, and the results I obtain are really clear, so they're easy to apply right away. We're trying to improve their lives.